Hola, Abimani here again, and today we're going to be treating automatic table of contents. What do I mean how to create, generate your table of contents on Microsoft Word automatically. I'm sure what most of you guys are doing is typing your table of contents and putting dot 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 that most likely won't write. But with this video, you're going to know how to generate it automatically and create it in just 2 steps. You're going to be able to create your table of contents in less than 2 minutes. I'm really serious. As well, how I'm going to do that, I'm going to show you using Adewole Esther's report. She sent her report to me, and for the sake of this video, we decided to show you guys how to create it. So I'd like you guys to watch to the end and see how it is, and also try that on your report and send me feedback. Now, for feedbacks, I know you guys have questions. Like, some of you guys have questions pertaining to your defense or pertaining to a problem you're having creating your report. So what we resorted to do is to create a WhatsApp group. We're going to put the link in the description. You guys should drop your questions there. And then if we reach up to 100 subscribers by the end of this video, we're going to create a follow-up video to really answer your questions. And I'm going to do that. So guys, that's the goal, 100 subscribers. So the normal routine, like, comment, subscribe, and with that said, today's video, as I said, we're going to be creating automatic table of contents. And basically what we're doing first is going through what styles are in Microsoft Word and their importance. The second thing will be generating this automatic table of contents, and then we'll be comparing how it's much better to manually typing your table of contents. So with that said, let's move to the work. Yeah, so this report belongs to Adewole Esther, and she's been a very great help to me in getting this message across to most of you guys. So I requested for a report to use as an example for what automatic table of content is for you guys. So now, getting straight to it, this is certification. These are just the introductory pages. Let's go to the main work. The abstract, pretty fine. So now, I want to make this section table of content section. So how do we go about it? First, you have to organize your work. How do you organize your work? According to styles. So when I say styles basically means headings. Like, if you're talking about styles, you're talking about things like this: heading 1, heading 2, heading 3. As simple as that. That's what styles are. So how are you going to do? You know that when you're writing reports, basically the topic is like heading 1, and that's true. So we're going to make chapter 1 and student industrial work experience scheme. That's chapter 1 together now. I'm going to make it heading 1. Yeah, then the next thing, okay, it doesn't need full stop yet. The next thing being introduction is going to be heading, it's going to be heading two. Now, of course, this is not how it's going to be in your report, but you know, you can also modify your headings. For example, I want this to be Times New Roman, coming Times New Roman. I want it to be 14, and I want it to be black. So let's put it like that. I want it to be both, but that's depending on you. I don't know what you should use or what you want to use. Okay, so you see it's been corrected automatically. So that's heading two. Yeah, heading two. The topic itself is heading one, so that is heading two. So since that is heading two, this one is going to be what? This is also going to be heading two. How do you know which is which heading? Based on, you're going to know because of 1.2. Now 1.2, you know these are 2 figures, 2 digits. So that will be heading 2. You can use that as a simple guide. You know, when something comes under historical background of CWS, it's going to be like 1.2.1. So in that case, I'm going to use heading 3. So with that, this is going to be heading, let's make this heading 2. Yeah, I have a feeling we should make heading 2 bold. You could decide otherwise for yourself, but let's just make it bold for this purpose. Okay, so it's been made bold. Well, it's not updated. Don't know why. Yes, update. Okay, so it's on board, and okay, yeah, it's been corrected. And you notice that this one has also been corrected. Now this should be 1.1.1. Yeah, just for inclusion there. Okay, moving to the next one. Next one, objectives, it should also be heading 2 as well, 1.3. The next one, okay, still the same thing. Functional with 2, okay, heading 2. And I think that should be all, okay. For this one, heading 2,
for the next editor as well. Okay, yeah, moving on. So this is a typical problem in that you have chapter 2 falling into the same page as chapter 1. So in cases like this, what you just do is come beside here and then come to insert, then you insert a page break. A page break basically separates the two, so that no matter what I write on this page, it's not going to overflow to this other page. It's just a new page. Alright, so for chapter 2 now, let's just use chapter 2 as another example. Obviously, you should do this yourself. So this is going to be what? Yeah, this is going to be heading. This is going to be heading 1 as well. It's going to be heading 1. Then the next will be heading 2. After heading 2, you go on the next. This is now 2.1.1. So you know that that's going to be heading 3. Then you move this at the back. You could edit heading 3 yourself. You know I said that by modify. But let's not take time on that. Let's not take time on that. Let's just move on. The next thing we have is okay, still heading 2. Heading 2. This is heading 3. The next is heading 3 as well. Okay, so this organogram which your report should have. Okay, also heading 2. And alright, this is an organogram. This is the organogram. Now for this one, it's also heading 2. Heading 2. You should know how you should space your work so that you don't fall into situations like this. For this one I can't. So this is heading 3. Heading 3 and I want to see, okay, this is an example of heading 4 now. Very good example. This is heading 4. The next is heading 4. I don't like the way this heading 4 is in italics, so I come here to modify. I'm just going to remove the italics and then I'm going to make it back to Times New Roman, which is recommended text. I'm going to make it black. So this is as simple as it is then. Okay, you see they both changed. They both changed. Okay, this is another example of heading 4. Keep heading 4. And yes, this is an A heading 5. So I come to here, heading 5. I could choose to make that black. I advise you to make everything black, basically. Okay, and whenever you modify any heading, it does the same, it changes it on every other heading. Okay, so with that done, I believe you guys know how to edit this thing. This is also 5, so click on it, put heading 5. Okay, so I'm going to skip every other one now, and then I'm going to pause the video. I'm going to format the work to the end. I'm going to put some styles for everything to the end. Chapter 3 contains the most work, so I'm going to put chapter 3 in order, and then when I'm done, I'm going to restart the video and make the table of contents. Alright, so chapter 3 took quite a while. This is chapter 4. Obviously, you know how it is. The both of them, heading 1. Okay, it's been formatted. I formatted this. The summary, heading 2. You can see here, heading 2. What else? Yeah, this is also heading heading 2 as well. That's heading 2. This, heading 2. And then the conclusion here, again, heading 2. Esther kind of formatted her own differently, and that's the beauty of the report. It doesn't have to be rigid. You can actually format it in a way that best communicates your message. So now this is the references, and of course your reference is heading 1. Yeah. So coming back to the front page, let me just save this right here. Coming back to the front page, I'm going to come to the next certification as well. Certification is going to be heading 1. Acknowledgement also heading 1. Education is the same thing. It's so much education. And then abstract. Okay, abstract also the same thing, heading 1. Okay, since it's all done, everything is in place. Next thing I'm going to do is to call out the table of contents. Now, many of you go through the process of typing and putting dot, 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 dot to make sure that they are aligned. But this is going to blow your mind that it is as simple as it is. So let me take this, clear it out, and then I'm going to come to references. You know, table of contents is the kind of reference, actually. So I come to references, table of contents. So it tells me which form I want, this one or this. So I'm going to choose the second one, table of contents. So I click it, and then like here you go, man. It's here you go. Everything is in place already. You have your certification, your acknowledgement, your education, abstract, everything is already arranged accordingly. If there's anything that is not right here, you can as well correct it in the document and then come back here. It's going to be like automated there. It's going to be corrected there already. And this is like the best way to use Microsoft Word to your advantage. It's really using it like someone that is educated, not the way we use it in school, which is it just undervalues it. Okay, so this is it. Let me say I want to just jump ahead and go to my reference from here. You know, I could click reference and then it's going to take me there. Let me say I want to go to chapter 1 from here. I'm going to click on, let me just click here, chapter 1, enter, and I'm in chapter 1. It's as straightforward as that. Okay, for example, let me say I made corrections. Let me say this chapter 1, I want to call it chapter 1, then A. Chapter 1A. So I just write it there, then I come to update from table of contents. Let me say I want to update the entire table. I click the entire table because it's not only about the number. And then I go back there. I don't see that it has changed. It's now chapter 1A. So the good thing about this is when you make your manual table of contents and you, let's say, add more pictures somewhere, you will have to go back and change the whole number, like the number of everything. So let me just come here and kind of disrupt the page number from this place. I want to put after this place only. I just want to take it down. Okay, so you see that COS Industrial Work Experience is on page 9 and chapter 1 is on page 8. Okay, so go to update table and then just update the entire table. It's not really taking off. Okay, so it's all updated. Let's go and see what it is. Where is it? So you see automatically here you go, this has been updated already. This has been updated tracking. So it's that simple. I want to jump to references now and then I click references, press enter, and then I'm there. So this is really one of the best ways you can use Microsoft Word to your advantage. And that being that, so I encourage you guys to subscribe and help grow this channel. Comment them, see how this video has helped you, and yeah, see you next time.